Here in the courtyard of Malakal Hospital in southern Sudan, the question of independence from the north is on everyone's lips. These women, however, are here for an entirely different emergency. Sagena Wale is here with her son, who has Kala Azar, the Sudanese name for leishmaniasis.
I realized my child was sick because every night he had a fever and vomited. We took him to the hospital at Adon. From there he was referred to Malakal, where they found out he had Kala Azar.
Visceral leishmaniasis is endemic in southern Sudan. This year, however, the region is suffering its worst epidemic in 8 years. The disease is transmitted to humans by sandflies carrying the parasite.
Patients have severe anemia, they have fevers, weakness, malnourished, and become ill quite quickly after exposure to it. In terms of treatment, if people do not seek treatment, in about 95 to 98% of cases, it is fatal.
Yet a treatment that is effective in 95% of cases does exist. Ambisone is given to patients intravenously. But in this region devastated by insecurity and population displacement, most people don't even have access to basic health care.
One of the things that we see happening is that patients come very late because this is such a major journey for them to take. So people are reluctant to come and they stay home for a long period of time, and then by the time they get to us, they are so weak that it's very difficult to treat them successfully.
By the end of November 2010, Médecins Sans Frontières had treated 2,355 patients with Kala Azar in southern Sudan, 8 times more than at the same time the previous year. This health crisis is affecting a region already hard hit by other epidemics, as well as chronic malnutrition. Médecins Sans Frontières will remain committed to addressing the needs of the Haitian people this coming year. New hospitals, an emergency obstetrics unit, and the creation of a foundation are just some of the organization's planned projects for 2011. 1 year after embarking upon its largest ever emergency response, the NGO is witness to the ongoing lack of specialized care in Haiti. International aid has been unable to fully meet the needs of the Haitian people, whether for shelter, clean drinking water or cholera treatment.
La question des abris était bien sûr centrale, en tout cas pour les gens, même si elle n'était pas une urgence immédiate.
Shelter is a key issue for the people in any case, even if it wasn't an immediate emergency. We tend not to consider it our domain, where medicine and surgery. So, for the first few months at least, we left shelter issues to other actors who know and were supposed to be handling it. But a month and a half, 2 months later, we realized that in fact little had been done, that things hadn't gotten off the ground.
Immediately after the earthquake, MSF focused on medical and surgical emergencies. Post-operative and psychological care, as well as the distribution of water and tents, were added to the team's activities later. In mid-October, another disaster struck the Haitian people when cholera broke out and spread throughout the country. In 2.5 months, MSF teams treated 91,000 patients in 47 structures across the country. Patients need to be treated as quickly as possible.
Si les gens ne viennent pas rapidement au centre de santé, eh bien, ils risquent de ne pas y arriver tout court parce qu'ils vont décéder.
If patients don't reach a health center quickly, they risk not getting there at all. They could die on the way or arrive too severely dehydrated. The sooner they reach a health center, the easier it is to rehydrate them.
MSF received unprecedented support for its relief effort in Haiti. The organization received from donors 104 million euros, enabling the deployment of 8,000 staff members. The teams treated more than 400,000 people in a year.
Of the 104
million euros received for the earthquake emergency in Haiti, 94 million euros were spent on the response to the earthquake relief effort. The remaining 10 million euros were used for the cholera emergency, which struck Haiti towards the end of the year. All of the funds raised for the Haiti emergency were spent in 2010.
Médecins Sans Frontières has budgeted 46 million euros to finance its different projects in Haiti in 2011. At the end of October, Pointe Noire, a town in southwestern Congo, was struck by a poliomyelitis epidemic. In just a few weeks, the virus affected more than 500 people, killing more than 200. At the request of the Ministry of Health, an MSF team intervened to help treat patients. Paralysis caused by the virus most commonly affects the lower limbs. If it reaches the respiratory system, however, it can be fatal. Rapid treatment, particularly physiotherapy, can improve the patient's physical recovery.
The effects of the disease are largely determined within the first 6 weeks. Most of the patients we're treating here were admitted to the program in time. We teach them how to live with their disabilities and to be as autonomous as possible.
By the end of December, the MSF teams were no longer admitting new cases into intensive care and were able to focus on treating the 100 or so patients, providing them, when necessary, with braces or other orthopedic devices.
When I got here, I couldn't move my legs. I was paralyzed. But now, with all the exercises, physiotherapy and massages, I can move them again and I can stand up. I still can't really walk, but it's much better than before.
At the peak of the epidemic, before the MSF teams arrived, many patients were discharged from the hospital not having received physiotherapy. MSF is trying to track those patients down in order to provide them with the care they need. Messages broadcast on the radio or through the church have brought a few patients back to the hospital, but the majority remain unfound.
No one at home has a job. My husband can't work, nor can I. I'm sick, I have dizziness and can't work. Yesterday I felt sick and dizzy and had to spend all day lying down. I couldn't move. Today at least I could leave home.
This woman has come to the MSF health clinic in Kalinovskaya in northern Chechnya. Treatment is free here. She hopes the doctors will be able to diagnose what is wrong with her. This is a rural area and there's a distinct shortage of health staff. The paediatric and gynaecology clinics opened by MSF last August are in great demand. The birth rate is high in Chechnya. Women generally have 5 or 6 children. The MSF health clinics in Grozny, Chechnya's capital, are busy too. The paediatricians see about 50 children a day.
We mainly see respiratory illnesses, a common cold, for example, that develops into a serious illness, pneumonia, tracheitis, bronchitis, ear infections. They tend to be minor illnesses that become serious. We often get children with several illnesses, acute respiratory infections, diarrhea, an ear infection maybe, conjunctivitis. So you've got a sore throat. I'm going to send you to hospital, to the Grozny No. 2 hospital, okay?
This little girl has a pulmonary infection and her condition is deteriorating. She needs to be referred to hospital. Médecins Sans Frontières opened its first clinics in Grozny in 2005. Since the end of the war, relative calm has returned to the country, but poverty continues to prevent many people from having access to healthcare.